Battlefield 1's Incursions mode is DICE's proper attempt to bring some competitive play to the franchise. It's a smaller scale mode, but it still encompasses the full Battlefield experience with destruction, team play, vehicles, and the chaos that you've come to expect. At the moment, I can't show you any footage of the new mode. I will be able to soon, so stay tuned for that, but I have some information that's been released by the press in certain articles. The one I'll be using today is from Red Bull, and it gives you probably a 70% run through of Incursions and covers all of the high level points. So this video will tell you at the moment everything you need to know. So first and foremost, Incursions scales down the standard Battlefield experience to a 5v5 offering, into a conquest-style game mode with three flags. And the first map that DICE has chosen to put the game mode onto is Giant Shadow. Don't worry, however, the map has been heavily modified to fit the 5v5 scenario. It still looks like Giant Shadow, but it plays differently. The mode focuses heavily on squad play, and the mode rewards you for squad play actions, which are almost imperative to execute if you want to win. Incursions is limited slightly from the standard Battlefield 1 loadout system, whereby the team at DICE has created a set of kits that you can pick from, each with their own specific role that you'll need to take on and play. Essentially, they've created a draft system. The kits are subsets of the classes you already use in standard multiplayer, but they can only be chosen by one person in the five-player squad. This was confirmed in the Incursions trailer when a player picked a kit from the draft and it became greyed out. With the rest of your squad, you'll need to pick kits which cover off all of the areas during a match you think you're going to need, both offensively and defensively. There are dedicated vehicle driver kits as well, so that when a vehicle becomes available to use, players can jump in and utilize it. Those kits will feel a bit weaker when you're on foot, waiting for the vehicle to spawn, but once they're behind the wheel, that's where all the damage can be done. The preset kits in the draft focus on certain weapons and gadgets, and to briefly mention, not all of the weapons and gadgets are utilized. DICE has curated a set to pick from that best suit the roles that they know work in a competitive environment, and more of them will be added in the future should they be needed. Now, the scoring system, an extremely important aspect, of course, in any competitive mode, is fairly different to what you might have experienced in other games like Counter-Strike and Call of Duty. Because Battlefield is more complex in some of its gameplay mechanics, the scoring system is designed to reward players who utilize those and work with their team. There are two layers to the scoring system. First of all, the overall score, and then the underlying set system. Let's start with the sets. Each set is made up of 15 tickets, and whichever team gets to 15 first wins the set. Winning a set awards your team 1 point to your overall score, and the first team to reach 11 points wins the game. It's like a game of tennis where you play multiple games within a set, and whoever wins the set gets 1 point towards their overall score. This system allows for multiple comeback opportunities, not just by winning a few sets in a row to regain the lead, but within each set. Because both teams are working towards that 15 ticket mark to win the set, it could go right to the wire with 14-14 and one ticket deciding the set. Plenty of clutch moments are sure to come out of this Incursions mode. Now, there is a half-time mechanic after 10 sets have been played to break up the action a little bit. Now, the idea behind this scoring system is to make sure at all times either team has a chance to win. If you have a couple of bad sets, you can quickly catch up by winning the next two. Or even within a set, if you have a bad 30 seconds and you get squad wiped by the enemy team, then you may still have a chance to win by getting to 15 tickets first. Now, at the moment, I can't actually reveal how you earn tickets to win sets, and that's something I will be able to discuss in another video later in September. I will say, however, that understanding how the scoring system works is hugely important to you winning the round. A lot of talk around Incursions is focused on whether the game mode will actually be any fun to play. And echoing something that Flakfire said in his recent video, After sessions of Incursions were played at Gamescom, we all had an allotted hour to play the game mode in. 90% of people who just played asked if they could play again. Some people managed to slide into multiple slots, and they got to play more and more, and the only reason we wanted to do that was because the game mode was extremely addictive. The key thing to remember here with Incursions is that while it does differ slightly from the other standard Battlefield modes, with its draft system, the sets, and the overall scoring system, underneath, it's still the same game. The weapons handle the same, the movement system is the same, and the vehicles to an extent are the same as well, although they've been slightly tweaked to make sure they don't steamroll the rounds. DICE is currently working on a big weapon balancing pass for Battlefield 1 anyway, to try and bring some weapons and gadgets into a better position. And that's something you'll likely see me cover from the CTE in the next few days. Now, I will say at the moment, because Incursions hasn't publicly been shown off yet, although that will be happening in September with the closed alpha on PC, it is hard to apply all of this information to anything. It's not really very tangible information at the moment because you can't relate it to some gameplay in the background. All I can really do for you guys is tell you that the game mode does work. It was good fun when I played it. It has a big future, I think, because the team behind it are very dedicated, and the people that played it, lots of professional gamers, Battlefield community members, and the gaming press, they really appeared to like it as well. So it seems to be off to a good start. That's everything on Incursions right now. I hope this video gave you some idea about what Incursions is and what it will become, and I can't wait to show you guys some gameplay later on in September. Leave me your comments down below, let me know your thoughts on Incursions, and I'll be down there reading as many as I can. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.